Myanmar and covers Sino-Pak excess in arms supply to two rebel groups in Rakhine. Myanmar is believed to have discovered an alleged Sino-Pak axis that is supplying China-made arms to two rebel groups in the country's rest of Rakhine province to target Indian assets, including Kaladin multimodal project. The groups are also allegedly fueling terror both in Myanmar and across the border in Bangladesh. The nexus has been revealed following arrests by the authorities of Thailand along the Thai-Myanmar border. The Thai authorities shared details of the investigation with Myanmar's security establishment. ET has learned the revelations came to light close on the heels of Myanmar Army's top brass expressing public displeasure against China's role in fueling insurgency in the country. In late June, Thai security officials intercepted a shipment of weapons in the town of Mae Sot across the border from Mayawadi in Myanmar's Karen state. They seized a large cache of brand new Chinese-made weapons and detained two Thai citizens. ET has reliably gathered the Thai authorities investigating the weapons shipment have since made additional arrests. The seized weapons were ultimately destined for Rakhine state bordering Bangladesh. Persons familiar with the developments indicated to ET, the Rakhine Army, AA, in the Rakhine state had placed orders for the seized weapons. One of the persons quoted above informed, in Myanmar, the AA is designated as terrorist organizations. Kaladin multimodal project passes through the Rakhine state and AA has been targeting the project that can transform the region. The Kaladin project connects Kolkata with Sitpot in Rakhine state by sea. Besides the two Thai nationals, Pakistani nationals were also involved in procuring the weapons seized in Mae Sot. These men are believed to have previously lived in Cambodia before moving to Thailand, branching into larger underground networks and terrorism links in the region. According to a recent report in Myanmar's leading English media, the Irrawaddy Thai security establishment is closely monitoring the activities of Pakistanis living in Mae Sot. There are significant differences between the IRSA and the AA. The IRSA has been accused of having connections with foreign terrorist groups. According to the Irrawaddy report, Abdus Qadus Burmi, a Pakistani of Rohingya descent based in Karachi who is considered the group's mentor, has called for jihad in Myanmar and has well-documented links to the Lashkar-e-Taiba. Burmi has even appeared at meetings with the late Chief Hafiz Mohammad Syed in Pakistan, and the IRSA has received donations and training from the broader Islamist terror networks in East Asia. According to the Irrawaddy, its leader, Atiullah, was born in Pakistan and raised in Saudi Arabia. The IRSA targeted minorities in Rakhine state in 2017 and over the past few years launched daring attacks on more than 30 police posts in an army base in Rakhine, resulting in the deaths of dozens of IRSA insurgents as well as security personnel. According to Myanmar authorities, the IRSA is trying to procure additional arms as Myanmar army has intensified operations in Rakhine state. Thai and Myanmar authorities have reportedly stepped up vigil to launch a crackdown on arms smuggling.